In 1988, someone heard me give a public talk on forgiveness and invited me to go into the prison to give a similar talk. I went into the prison that morning expecting two or three people to show up. And out of a population of 700, 120 men were waiting at 9 o'clock in the morning for the talk to begin. I was blown away by their response.
The personality is made up of what's called many different sub-personalities.
I developed this course to teach emotional literacy skills because I saw that prisoners had a profound need and a deep yearning to make sense of their lives.
Emotions that we identify with, and to the degree that we identify with any of them, we see.
Why were they there? How could they change their lives? How could they create a future that was different from their past?
So what you're saying is, right, instead of keying in on one fault of somebody, look at the whole picture of
exactly.
That person.
Just
today, this course is called Houses of Healing. As time passed, I saw that the course was making a huge difference for many participants. But because it was available to only a small number of people, I decided to write a book to bring the spirit and the content of the Houses of Healing course to incarcerated men and women around the country.
So emotional literacy, what do you think that might mean, emotional literacy?
Emotional literacy is the ability to read our own feelings, to identify, to manage, and express our feelings in a mature way.
Exactly. Thank you, Ramon.
It has to do with self-understanding, with being able to cope with the stress and the ups and downs of everyday life. It has to do with being emotionally mature.
And I think we have an obligation to make prison a place, you know, a place where people can come out, knowing who they are.
Emotional literacy forces us to ponder the question deeply, who am I really?